analyze a short story, The Library of Babel. This story is a kind of puzzle that we will try to solve. This is written by Argentine writer Jorge Luis Borges. He was an essayist, a short story writer, a poet, and a translator. His writing style is different from all others. He was one of the founders and principal practitioners of postmodernism. Illusion is the most important part in his fictional world. This story is typical of Borges' style. It has little plot, little characterization, and little conflict. His stories are known for the novelty of ideas. He wrote this story when he was working as a librarian in the city library. It was published in 1941. The story is told in first person point of view by one of the librarians working in that vast, perhaps infinite library. Now, this story is actually an allegory. I hope you all know what is an allegory. An allegory is any piece of work which has two meanings, a surface meaning and a hidden meaning. We will analyze both the meanings, but first of all, I would like to tell you something about the title of the story. The title of the story is The Library of Babel, as I have already told you. But the interesting thing is this word Babel. He has not used this word even once in the story. Then why he has used this word in the title? There is a biblical story behind it. According to that story is mentioned in Genesis, and according to that story, the descendants of Noah were living in an area in Babylon. They settled in a land named Shinar. And the population was growing, and they spoke the same language. So they decided that they should build a tall and proud symbol of how great they have made their nation. They decided to build a tower that could reach the heaven, so that they could be same as God, and then they would not need any God. So they started building their tower, but God was not happy with this pride and arrogance of his people. So he made them speak different languages so that they could not communicate and they could not work together to build their tower. The tower was named the Tower of Babel. Babel means a kind of confusion. So this story is a kind of reminder that one must obey the orders of God, and one must not try to build a successful but godless world, because that's impossible. And why he has used this word Babel in the story? Because in the library there were many books that belonged to different languages. So he has referred to this biblical story in his short story, The Library of Babel. Now we will discuss the structure of the library. The library housed all the books that ever written or yet to be written. The books were ordered non-hierarchically, means all the volumes were equally important. There were innumerable hexagonal rooms. In each room, four walls were taken up by bookshelves, and on the remaining walls, there were small nooks on which even readers could sleep. Then there were spiral staircases in all the hallways that would allow the readers to travel in all the rooms above and below. And in all the hallways, there were mirrors. But the interesting and confusing thing about the library is that the books were highly ordered, but they were practically unintelligible. In each bookshelf, there were 5 shelves, and in each shelf, there were exactly 32 books. And all the books contained exactly 410 pages. And on each page, there were exactly 40 lines. Each line contained 80 characters. And if we talk about the alphabets, each book contained 25 unique characters. The title of the books were irrelevant to its contents. The reader were unable to read it, and they even wondered whether they are written in a kind of language that is still unknown, or they are somehow encoded. The narrator of the library was sure of the fact that this library is created by a god, because it has always existed and it has no end. Hundreds of years ago, an enlightened man discovered something that changed the paradigmatic way of thinking about the library. He argued that there are no two identical books in the library, and he claimed that all the books are intelligible and they contained some hidden truths that are profound and enlightening. After this secret, many people tried to know about that hidden truth, but they failed. They either dissolved into violence or went insane. Then there came three groups. The first group was that of the inquisitors. They focused their attention on how this library, how and why and when this library began, instead of focusing on the books. Then the second group, composed of the men who were disillusioned, they believed that they are never going to discover anything, however hard they try. The third group was that of the purifiers. They gave the suggestion that they must destroy the books that are meaningless according to them, because it will help the others who will come after them. They will then have less books to explore. So in this manner, they destroyed volumes of books, but it was equally useless. The narrator rejected all the three camps. According to him, the books are intelligible. And he questioned whether the inhabitants of the library have the grasp of their own language. He stated that the library will be there always, even if there will be no one left to explore it. Now, what is the symbolic meaning of this story? The library is used as a metaphor for the universe in which we live. The universe which is highly ordered. The universe in which everyone is equal. And the librarians, they are human beings who try to make sense of all the complex mysteries of the universe. The message that he wants to convey is that the library is infinite and the universe is vast and more complex than human beings can fathom. However hard we try to make sense, however hard we try to simplify it, to explain it, we can never grasp it. And we human beings have the ability to destroy and preserve the parts of the universe. The mirrors that he has used, the mirrors that he has referred to in the library, also have symbolic importance. However, he has not focused much upon the mirrors. Mirrors are meant to duplicate perfectly, but they actually present the exact opposite of whatever exists on the viewer's side. And when many mirrors are faced together, they create an illusion of infinity. The same thing is taken up by Borges in this, and he indicated towards a confusion whether the library was really infinite or perfectly duplicated books existed there. This is a mystery. In the same manner, the universe is a mystery. So this story states that universe holds transcendental meanings that we human beings can never grasp. Thank you.